Right, watch your foot there, love, because that's a fast tractor you're driving. Don't you going off the air. No! Hello everybody and welcome back to Simulate Gaming and welcome back to Sandy Bay here on Farming Simulator 17. Now as you can see, overnight we have had quite a bad snowstorm here on Sandy Bay. So what we had planned for this video is a little bit delayed because we needed to go and collect some animal equipment from the store. Because of course we have cows now and we're soon to be getting sheep and all that good stuff. But we're going to have a bit of trouble getting around because as you can see the yards are completely locked with snow. Now at the moment, it's not that deep. If I just find an area where I can show you the depth of it. Here, we'll do this shed, we'll do here. Yeah, so at the moment, it's not that deep, but it will obviously still snowing now, so it will get a lot deeper soon. So we want to act on this fast. So what we need to do is start clearing some paths so we can head down to the shop. Now, the council have already been through and done. If we skip down there, the lake is frozen, as you can see. The lake is completely frozen, which is a shame, although somehow the duck is still floating on it. We'll ignore that. yeah, the council have been through and done the roads themselves because it's not our job. So yeah, we are going to go... Where's that duck? I don't know how he's swimming on the frozen river, but there we go. Yeah, so we're going to go ahead and jump into one of our tractors today and we'll start clearing basically a path going from the main road up to the cow, wherever we're going to store them really, so this sort of area here, maybe up there towards the cows, and also on the other area as well. Now, I just want to go and check the cows actually, because some of them were outside when the snowstorm hit, so hopefully they're absolutely fine, but we'll have a look. We'll jump over this gate, get our torch on here. Now, if it's a little bit dark, I do apologise, it is, obviously it's snowing, so visibility isn't that great. We've got a bit of snow coming through the shed here, but it's not much, and all of the cows are outside. Be alright, girls. Don't worry, we'll have you some food and drink later on. Yeah, completely. The trough's completely empty. Now, the reason the water one is empty is because, of course, we knew the snowstorm was coming in. We had to go ahead and empty that, or else we'd have a frozen trough, which is not good. So, yeah, that's what we've had to do last night. So we need to go ahead and get that replaced as soon as possible. So, first of all, I think I know what tractor we're going to use today, and I also think I know which piece of equipment we're going to use today. So we'll open up the shed right here. Hopefully the door isn't frozen closed. Nope, absolutely fine. Cool. Now, I've had a lot of requests to use the John Deere. We will be using it very soon, but I don't want to risk putting like any strain on the engine or whatever. So we're going to be using that as a leveler, but we're going to be using it as a snowplow today. And we're also going to be using the case, because it's, out of all the tractors we have, I think that's the one that's rather, you know, possibly damaged. So what we're going to do is jump in to the tractor. We'll give the head tracking a bit of a reset here. There we go. Right. Let me just get comfortable in real life. Awesome. So we'll go ahead and get it booted up first of all. There we go. Well, that's something wrong with that John Deere. For some reason, the decals are white now. But yeah, we'll go ahead and get some lights on the situation here. Nice and cozy in here, I must admit. Cool. We're going to be using the front 3-point today. We have to ignore that computer. That is one of the glitches with this tractor. We'll try to look at it. Sort of ruins the immersion a little bit. But yeah, we'll get this all hooked up. There we go. Now, I will show you a bit about this plow in a minute. Now, this plow is... I keep saying plow, but everyone knows it's a leveler. This leveler is on the in-game mod hub, so I don't have a link for it, unfortunately. Just, if you're on console... No, if you're on PC, sorry. I don't know if it's on console, but if you're on PC, it should be in there somewhere, so just have a good old gander. It should pop through. Awesome. So, yeah, I'll just show you the leveler slash plow that we're using today. This is the... In fact, I can tell you what brand it is. Ready? This is the Stegman, or Stegman. Stegman or Stegman? Stegman? I'm going to go... Nah, Stegman. Stegman? I don't know. It's a German one, by the look of it. So we're going to be using this today. Of course, we can have it in narrow or wide. I think today we might just cut our work down and have it double the width. That might be the best solution. It does have lights on it as well, if I show you that. It's okay, there's the lights on the top, and they do work, which is absolutely fantastic. We'll get our beacon lights on. That's one of the main reasons, because we've got the little strobe lights at the front, which I think looks really cool with the snowplow. And we'll get this all leveled down like that. Cool, now hopefully we'll start ploughing this ground away, shall we? So I'm going to try and push it off to the corner for now. It will melt away eventually. As you can see, it is working quite well there. Although we need our four-wheel drive on simulate. Well done, sir. So yeah, we're a little bit, there we go, lower that down again. What's the word I'm looking for? We're a little bit remote at the moment, because we're in the middle of nowhere with no means to get to us. Like, no one from the outside can get to us unless they're driving tractors as well. So it's not great. It's not a great situation to be in today. It's a little bit of a panic going on here in Sandy Bay. All the locals and stuff, they have had their roads cleared now, which is good. But still, everything's a little bit of a shock to the system for them, because we don't usually get this much snow down in Devon. Just lift that up like so. Cool. Though the road's roughly done, this dirt road here, well, gravel road's roughly done, so we don't need to worry about it too much. I will go over it once. So we'll go down to the main road here. And turn around. Now, when I saw it was snowing last night, I was a bit worried that we'd have to do the roads, but nope, luckily we do not. Are you going to wait there, or are you going to smash into me? Oh, we're in a bit of a sticky situation here. Well done, guys, well done. Right, in that case, we'll go into the sheep field and turn around then. Okay, let's try that again, shall we? We'll see if, like I said, there's not much on this road, but we'll give it a go anyway. Let's get it all leveled up properly. Awesome. Now, if this video looks a little bit weird, it's probably because I've had to make it a little bit brighter in editing, because it is quite dark, unfortunately. The weather's sort of making it a little bit dark around here. So, yeah, if it looks a bit weird, it's just because I've turned up the brightness a little bit. Come on. It's not the best road to be doing this on, that's for sure. Let's just whack you over here. Awesome. That should do it. The road's pretty much clear now at this point. We're not going to have any trouble getting down, that's for sure. So now we've just got to worry about the yard here, I suppose. Come on. Keep slipping on stuff. There we go. But what we're going to do is just push this to the back here. Hopefully it'll melt away. There we go. It's another one. I'll do some in third person so you guys can see. Now, usually I do all my stuff in first person, so it's a bit more realistic, but some of you guys probably actually want to see the snow being ploughed. Now, at the moment, there's no particle effect, so it sort of just disappears in front of the leveler. But it's still pretty cool. I mean, we've got snow in the game, finally. This is all the Seasons mod, by the way, for those of you wondering. Not a snow mod, it's literally all done through Seasons, which is really, really cool. Absolutely groundbreaking game. Right, let's back up a little bit. That should be enough. We're just going to make it a little bit wider for the people that like to take the corners a bit wide. And once again, I'll do it in third person so you guys can see. Let's just rotate that around a little bit. There we go. Make sure it'll crash into the gate. Right, is that going to make a massive mess now? No, it looks pretty fine. That's all right. We'll do the same again on this side. Oh. Slow down, Case. Slow down. When you hit the turbo, this thing flies. So it's a little bit dangerous to be using in the snow, but it's probably the most ideal tractor we've got for this sort of weather, at least. Oh. Lift it up a little bit. There we go. Right, actually, I'm going to take a thumbnail, guys, and I'll be right back. So bear with me. Right, so I've got my thumbnail. The FPS is a bit all over the place with this snow mod. That could be because I'm using this the beacons. We don't really need the beacons on yet. We'll get them turned off here. Oh. Let's go ahead and level this plough a little bit, because we want to go this way now. So I'm not sure where we're going to keep the snow around here, that's for sure. To be fair, the only thing that's in here is a baler, and we're not going to be doing baling for at least a few months, so we can go ahead and chuck it up against this door here. Hopefully it will still melt away. Hopefully I don't accidentally push it into the shed, because that would be a little bit awkward. Right, let's go ahead and lower this down. So yeah, we're just maintaining the yard today, basically. Trying to get all the snow away so we can continue doing some work, at least. It'll be really cool when these ploughs actually... or someone brings that snow plough that works for Seasons that actually has, like, the snow building up around the plough. That'd be really cool. I'm not sure if Seasons are working on it, or whether that's to do with the levelers themselves sort of thing. Nope, don't want to crash into the Hilux. Right, so just a little bit about the Seasons mod, breaking the immersion a little bit. So yeah, Seasons mod adds snow to the game in the winter time. So in the winter time, you're not guaranteed snow. So when you get Seasons mod, when it's released finally, don't expect snow every winter. It is a rare thing. If I press Control H, no, what is it? Control F? Oh, there is Control F. It's just a little bit delayed. So you can see we're expecting snow. You basically just got to check on the weather reports, basically. The one thing you are guaranteed is low temperature winds and stuff. So as you can see up in the top there, I'll show you what everything means. So we got frozen ground there is the first icon up in the right corner. Obviously that's pretty self-explanatory. It means the ground is frozen, so no groundwork can be done on it. There's also one that says wet ground, and that is not just after it's been raining. That is also in the morning as well, in the autumn. So you get the mountain, not the mountain dew. What we're talking about? You get, that's a drink. You get the morning dew and all that good stuff. So you won't be able to work with the morning dew as well. Well, you could, but it's gonna be soggy and you get stuck and all that good stuff. You do get stuck. I should mention, you do get tire slip and all that good stuff. There's a video of that on the Seasons Mod channel, YouTube channel, which I'll put a link to in the description box. What else we got? So yeah, after that we've got the current, well, today's weather. So as you can see, we've got the snowflake there, which means, well, it's more of a snowflake. That could just mean icy, but in our case it means snow. And then we've got two temperatures. So the top one is the wind temperature. So it's -3 degrees today, wind temperature. And underneath that, with the little plant, that is soil temperature. So as you can see, the soil temperature today is -1. So it's still below freezing point. So we're not going to be able to do any field work until it warms up a little bit. Hopefully that our winter barley is still growing away. It should be, because it does grow in the winter. Right, so after that, we've got the snow, which obviously it's snowing today. So that's what the snow icon means. And the little one next to that is the next day. So tomorrow it is sunny, because we've got a picture of a sun there next to that. And if I press F, it should confirm, Alt F, it should confirm that. So you can see there, Thursday, it is due to be sunny again. So hopefully the snow will melt away a little bit at least. Still going to be really, really cold. And then of course you've got the time and then the date. And then where it is. Now, that's changed a few times, the next piece. The next piece where it says 3rd of midwinter, that changes quite a lot. It used to say just the season. So it used to say, now it would say winter, the third day of winter. And then they change it to months. So it would say, for example, now it would say the 3rd of December sort of thing. But then it changed to early, mid, and late seasons. I kind of prefer it like that. Rainbow Dave has it in the months. Landy Kid has it the same as me, I believe. Now the days, in fact, I don't really show this off that often. I'll show you the Seasons Mod menu. Now bear in mind, the Seasons Mod menu is not available just yet. So this is still to be done. We've got Seasons Instructions, Keys, that basically puts everything here. Temperature is in Celsius or Fahrenheit. And then Seasons Length is 6 days. Now you can have 3, 6, 9, or 12, I believe. I've got mine on 6, of course. Snow, I haven't really played around with these just yet. One layer only. I think you can have it up to over 0.6 meters tall. Crop moisture is on, so that thing I've been ago I was telling you about the morning dew and stuff, you can turn that off if you want. And then snow tracks, when you change that to snow on, which gives you the deeper snow, then you can leave snow tracks as well. I didn't want to do that just yet because it's still early winter. Maybe we'll try out the actual snow in a future video, maybe, hopefully. So I think that's pretty much us done here. I do want to try and scrape past the Hilux without actually hitting the Hilux, because that'll be expensive for us. Let's back up a little bit. We should probably put our beacons on again, shouldn't we? There we go. So yeah, let's try and squeeze past the Hilux here without actually hitting the Hilux. There we go. Cool. So we're going to try and do this next bit all in one good sweep. Oh, that's the wrong way to simulate. Don't hit the Hilux. Oh, we hit the Hilux. Oopsie. That's going to be expensive. It wasn't me. It's my car, so it doesn't matter. But still. Let's get that folded away here, because we're slipping on the slippery ground here. Right, let's get it unfolded again here. Put it back into forwards. And yeah, we'll try and do this little alleyway in one good take. See if we can get it all cleared pretty much instantly. Push along here. We'll just push up against this wall for now. Now, one other thing I should tell you about the Seasons Mod, well, the snow in Seasons Mod, which is really cool. So if you leave a trailer outside, the trailer will fill of snow. If you leave a bucket outside, the bucket will fill of snow. It will eventually melt away. But yeah, if you leave anything open, any open containers outside, whether it's buckets, silage forks, trailers, tippers, trucks. In fact, I'm surprised there's nothing in the back of the Hilux. I think it's because the Hilux doesn't accept any grain or anything. So basically anything that accepts grain or silage or anything, they can get filled with snow, which I think is really cool. In fact, there might be something in the back of the Hilux. We'll check in a minute, but I'm pretty sure there's nothing in the back. Right, so that is the door where we need to feed them. So as long as that's clear, we should be good to go. Let's push that up here. Do a little bit more in third person so you guys can see what we're doing. Get the beacons off. I think it is that causing us FPS issues. Because you got those dodgy beacons on the front, and I think they're causing FPS issues. But we'll lower this down. We don't want it too low. Back in the forward. And we'll start clearing this last little bit away. There we go. The cows don't seem to care that it's snowing quite heavy. They're enjoying it. The girls are loving it. So, not really worried about their well-being, because they're having fun in the snow. But as long as we can feed them, that's all we care about. So we'll get this last little piece done here. Is there a four-wheel drive on? Yeah, I might turn the diff locks on as well. Not that we really need them, but... There we go. Now, some of you have probably noticed we're pushing up against the gate, and you're thinking, Sim, how are you going to get that out the gate? If we need to get into that field, we'll just go through the shed, because we're clearing out the shed anyway. Right, here we go. Right, so we are pretty much done here right now. So what we're going to do now is just clear the final bit. Now, I'm going to fold the plough up here, because we need to actually drive... Turn the diff locks off here. We need to go into the shed, because if we push it up... Actually, I'll just show you what I mean in a minute. I'll get out and show you, in the cold. Right, so we need to clear this a little bit here, so the trailers and stuff don't slip and get stuck. But of course, if we push it in this way, we're just going to push it into the shed, which we don't want. So we're going to go into the shed. We could move around in here, maybe. If not, we'll go for the other side. There's a little bit of snow in here that we seem to have missed with the snow mask. Maybe fix that later on. But yeah, we're going to push it out, basically. So we'll give that a go now. And let's close the door up. You can hear a plane go overhead. Obviously, the snow isn't that bad. But it must be expected to clear pretty soon if they've got planes flying overhead. Right, let's see if we can do this. I don't think I've got any buttons mapped out to my likes just yet. Right. Can we do this? Looks like we've managed. Look at that. Mad skills, fam. There we go. Cool, so now we'll go ahead and get this unfolded. Hopefully it'll fit through the gate. Actually, that's one thing, and I think that's more to do with the game than the seasons mod. It'd be cool if there was a way to map out so the snow doesn't fall on the snow mask as well. Maybe that's an idea for them? I don't know. I think that's to do with the actual giants, though, if I'm honest. Right, let's go ahead and push this out if we can. There we go. That's a camera mode simulator. There we go. Did a pretty messy job of that, so we'll go ahead and give it another go. We only got to like here. Rotate the camera around. That's more like it. Get it all. If a job's worth doing, it's worth doing well. That's what my granddad always said. So we're pretty much done now. Fine, I know I've been saying this for ages, but I think we are actually done now. So as long as we can get the trailers in and all that good stuff, we should be good. Not going to bother ploughing the field on the other side. It's pretty much pointless at this point because it's grass and mud. It's just going to get sludge anyway. Get rid of this fine a little bit here. Awesome. We're pretty much done now. That's it. So all we want to do is make sure we can get the trailers through the yard and stuff. So we've got this huge mound of snow now, which hopefully will melt away. We've actually pushed it through the gate there, which is... actually, I'll just turn the torch on in case it's a bit dark on the screen. So yeah, we've sort of pushed it through the gate. We're absolutely fine. It will melt away. If not, we can go pick it up with a bucket and move it manually. So let's just quickly jump back into the case. I just realised I forgot to open the door realistically. It's because I've been using vanilla tractors lately and I'm sort of out of touch with that stuff. Let's turn that lights off. We don't need them. Actually, there's one thing I forgot to do. Let's quickly turn the lights again, the back lights on again, just to light us up. Oh, she doesn't like the snow. She's hiding now. Don't worry, girls, we'll get you fed as soon as possible. So now the last thing to do today, guys, is to go and finally pick up our equipment before the snow builds back up again. So we'll get that closed down. That was the wrong button. There we go. I had to press the IC button, but I accidentally pressed the ignition button instead. So that'll do nicely. We're not going to bother taking the case down. We'll let it rest now. We've been pushing it quite hard today. So we are going to jump into the fast track and the John Deere, because people have been asking for the John Deere. Actually, no, we will put this in the shed. I'll stop being lazy. Put it in the shed. Awesome stuff. So yeah, we've got to do this as quick as we can before the snow builds back up. I'll get it all packed away neatly in a minute, but for now, we'll just leave it here. We'll just lower the plow, get the lights off. Awesome. So we haven't got any workers in today. Obviously, it's a snow day. I still haven't done the thing. Dang it. So we're going to get our missus to drive one of the tractors down. She's trained. She can drive the JCB, and we will take the John Deere. There we go. Now, I have said it in the previous video, but let me tell you about this John Deere, because there's still people moaning about it, and I shall tell you what is going on with this John Deere. So let me just go ahead, get our beacon lights on here. Can we jump out of here? Yes, we can. Let's get the... Oh, that's the wrong one. That's the right one. Cool. So we'll start this up for her. She knows how to drive. She's just a bit of a... She doesn't really know how to start the thing up. So we'll go ahead and get the lights on. Get it on to follow me here. Nope, that's the vulture you're following there. Come on, follow the John Deere. There we go. That's more like it. Oh, there she is. That actually was a girl. That was good. It's a bit more immersive. Right, so yeah, I'll show you about the John Deere now. I've had a lot of people say that the back of this John Deere is wrong. And you're absolutely right. This is the back of a 7R. Obviously, it's a 6230R. It's got a 6230R front. With some dodgy decals there. I'm not sure what this is. A lot of things are doing this on Farm Sim 17, but yeah. It is a completely different back, and the interior is also different. I'll just quickly get this down again with the foot pedal. Awesome. So basically, this is the 7R, and someone's put the 6R front on it. That's all it is, but it's still the best one I could find online. Some of the other 6Rs were completely messy and ugly and useless or full of bugs. So we went with this one in the end. Right, so with that said, let's go ahead and drive down to the store, shall we? Get our beacon lights on. Does this have beacons? Yes, it does. Cool. Look at this. Lovely clear pathway now. So hopefully they've ploughed the store as well, because that isn't our job. As long as we can get in there. Once again, the roads are done. Right, watch your foot there, love, because that's a fast tractor you're driving. Don't you going off the air. No! I took my eyes off the road for 3 seconds. Ah, good job it was frozen. We could have put that through then, and that would have been seriously, seriously dangerous if the John Deere went through the ice then. Right, you ready? She's stuck, isn't she? Come on. Nope, she's coming. And she's going to crash into that car. Boom! Right, so we sorted her out, I think. Yeah, she's slowly on her way. So we're just heading down to the store now. It looks like it's pretty much middle of the night, but if I get the clock up again, it's actually only 10 o'clock in the morning, so yeah, we need to do some video editing, I think, to make this look a bit brighter than it actually is. So if, once again, if it looks a bit weird, that is why. Are the beacons still on? Yes, they are. Right, we'll indicate. We'll indicate. The indicators don't work. Well, that's interesting. Like, in the cab, I mean. The cab ones don't work. I never realised that until now. But yeah. So we've got some second hand. I should also mention the equipment we're buying is second hand, because we've got a little bit of money, but not all that much. So until we could afford some good feeding equipment and that good stuff, we are... Oh gosh. The store isn't done after all. Wait. Watch your step. Right, get our four-wheel drive on there. If we had a CB radio, we'd tell her to put hers on as well. I thought the store would be done, but unfortunately it's not. If I knew that, we would have come down with the case and done it for them, but not to worry. Right, so this John Deere can take... But you can... Wait there a minute, my love. Alright, we'll take the feeder. Now, I don't even know if this feeder works, but it's the Lundberg one. As you can see, it's seen better days. But like I said, we are on a budget, so until we can get anything else done, this will do us nicely. There we go, hook that up there. Put her back into forward. Move her away. Cool. So we'll jump through to the case now. The case? What am I talking about? I just call this a case. How offensive. I'll jump into my little baby fast track. I love this tractor so much. And we'll hook up the water bowser. Now, this one is a little bit different. You may have seen this one on Ringelbach if you watch that series. But yeah, we need to jump out for this one. We don't need to, but I'll show you why in a second. So we'll quickly open the door. Get it hooked up. Now, as you can see, the foot is still down. We have to press V. Okay, let's try this side. It's acting a little bit weird today. I think it's because I got the triggers on the JCB, but press V. There we go. And the leg lifts up. So now it's fully attached. I don't know what's on the low hitch, but it is hooked up, I think. It used to work on this side. I'm not sure why it didn't work in this time. But anyway, let's let it done. We'll jump back in. Oh, we need to have the hood on for this, don't we? There we go. Right, let's get you... Oh, that's reverse. Let's get you back on to follow me. Now we need to give a little bit more distance this time. There we go. Control F. Make you 20 meters. That should be more than enough. This mod here, where the HUD's showing up at the top there, that is the mixing one, which works outside of the cab as well. And to turn it off, if you want, say you're not doing mixing, you can just press Control 1 and it turns it off. For those of you that didn't know that. Right, ready, love? Let's go. Beacons are on. I thought... I'm losing my mind. I thought we forgot to hook it up then. But no, we have got it. Right. We'll take it nice and slow. It's going to be a bit sloshy through here. We'll indicate out of here. Is she alright? I think so. Right, no cars should be coming. The roads are going to be a bit quieter today because obviously it's snowing. Not a lot of people like driving in the snow, so we shouldn't have that much worry. But there is going to be some people on the road at least. Speed limit's 30. We'll hook up the speed limiter there. Well, the cruise control. And we'll slowly head back to the yard. So she shouldn't have any trouble in the fast track, that's for sure. That thing is a beast. There's a car coming, no? Thank you. Right, go, 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 go. Oh, there's another car coming. Hopefully, she's going to be alright with that. Hopefully. Let's have a look. This has gone horribly wrong so far. Yeah, she's okay. She's stuck behind the car, but she should make it. Should have turned traffic off for this, realistically, shouldn't I? But, there we go. So the crops, I can't actually see. When we go past the field, we'll have a look. Hopefully they're not dead. Hopefully being the key word. Nope, they are still growing away there. There's our winter barley. You can just see it poking through the snow there. So the snow shouldn't really affect it, because it's winter barley. It may slow it down a little bit. But he ain't going to stop it, that's for sure. Right, let's turn it up here. Like so. I can hear the JCB, actually. Where is she? Pushing her way through. There she is. Cool. So like I said, now we've got this lovely clear area. We can easily access the shed. We don't actually need it just yet, actually, because we haven't got any bells, but at least we have it now. Now, I need to dedicate something to our animal trailers and our animal stuff. For now, we'll just put them in with the tractors just for a minute. Awesome, there we go. Get that turned off, get that turned off. Beacon lights off. I think our lights are already off. Yes, they are. Cool. That's that off now. We'll jump into the fast track. So I'm going to leave it here. Thank you very, very much for joining me on this very, very cold morning on Sandy Bay. Hopefully you guys found it a bit interesting as well. Unfortunately, we didn't do much farming today because one, it's winter, and two, we couldn't really access anything because of all the snow. Now, hopefully this won't get much deeper, but rumours are we have a really even worse snowstorm coming up very, very soon. So hopefully we don't get completely barricaded in by snow. Let's get that in here. We want to get everything in as soon as we can, basically. We don't want anything freezing over. Oh, ready? Turn, turn, turn. We'll just leave the water bowser on this tractor for now, because we need to give him a drink as soon as possible. We're going to do that? Yes, there we go. Okay, enter forwards. I think the lights are on. What about our beacons? Yeah, they're on. Turn them off. We'll jump out. So yeah, thank you very, very much for joining me in this episode. If you did enjoy, please slap that thumbs up button. It really does mean a lot. Hit subscribe to see more from myself. I've been Simulate Gaming, and I'll see you in the next one.